In the previous video, we discussed what a MUX is and its importance in routing signals. We also understood how signals were selected using selector lines and some terminology related to MUX. We learned the working of 2:1 MUX and its truth table. Now, let us continue ahead from this previous discussion. In the previous videos, we learned about K-maps and how to simplify circuits using them. To draw K-maps, we need a truth table. On the screen, you can see a truth table for a 2:1 multiplexer. The inputs are S, B, and A, and the output is Y. Using our knowledge of K-maps, we can create the following map. After grouping the terms, we can reduce the output equation to Y equals S bar A plus S into B. This equation can be realized using a logical NOT gate, a Boolean AND gate, and a Boolean OR gate, as shown. When S is 0, the AND gate connected to input A is active and will output A. Similarly, when S is 1, the AND gate connected to input B is active and will output B. One can write truth tables for different kinds of multiplexers and understand how the circuits are realized. Let us consider the IC seen here, 74LS153. This IC is a 4:1 dual MUX IC. From its name, we can infer that it has 4 inputs of which any one can be selected at a time. Since inputs are 4, the number of selector lines required will be 2. Let us bring up the datasheet for this IC. In the datasheet, we can see the connection diagram and the function table. From the connection diagram, we can see there are 2 sets of input lines and 2 outputs. But both these sets are controlled by the same selector lines A and B. We can turn one set on or off using the strobe line 1G and 2G at pin 1 and 15 respectively. When the strobe line is low, that particular set will be active. Let us build a circuit using this IC. We will use set 1, selected using strobe 1G to simulate the 4:1 MUX. We will compare the results with the function table. When B and A are low, data line C0 is selected. When B is low and A is high, data line C1 is selected. When B is high and A is low, C2 is selected, and when both A and B are high, C3 is selected. In this manner, we have learned the workings of this IC and also how a 4:1 MUX works. Try to figure out how an 8:1 or 16:1 MUX will work and how many selector lines will they have. Drop your answers in the comments below. Thanks for staying till the end. We'll meet soon with a new video on MUX. Till then, stay calm and keep learning.